David's going to try and drive through that cluster. Not a great outcome, but there is a cut on to corner.
Oh, Davies 50.
Long straight red, didn't hit it quite flush.
One.
Again, Davies had to drive through a cluster. And the best he's left is a thin cut black with the rest. The reds have opened perfectly. Davies deceptively low in the world rankings at the moment, down at 31. He's proved in the last couple of days that
Bramble,
he's worthy of higher than that.
Mark Davies.
Robertson thinking of rolling up to that red on the side cushion via the black cushion. Choosing something else. Decided he didn't have a safety and tried to pot his way out of trouble. But this red along the black cushion is certainly possible. Corner pockets have been pretty sympathetic this week. I think if he hits it right, it'll go in. Turned out there was an alternative to middle. Would have had better position on the blue but for the kick. Took most of the speed out of the cue ball.
6.
Very good chance now. This effort was set up by a very good safety from Davis. Robertson couldn't really see a safety and was forced into a very difficult long pot.
Another couple of reds with colours.
38.
And see him comfortably past the post in this opening frame. Well, play to come round for black when just the red would have left Robertson needing two snookers. As it is, the difference is 56 and Robertson can still win. Wanted to be above the blue though.
6.
Paul Cannon on the red underneath the pink. Oh. Forgot to pot the black.
Neil Robertson, sir.
So, after all, Robertson does need two snookers.
First frame, Mark Davis.
No need for further action. Mark Davis leads Neil Robertson by a frame to nil. Four players ended the round robin stage with four wins from six matches. Neil Robertson topped the group. The frames tally with 16 to 9, with Davis with 15 to 9, Ryan Day 15 to 13, and Barry Hawkins 12 to 10.
Second frame. Neil Robertson to break.
On the thick side, that's why the cue ball is so far short of the balk line.
One.
Didn't expect to flick the black.
Eight.
It was a natural to open the bunch from that thin clip. I don't know what he's got left though. Not an awful lot, is my impression.
Robertson 8.
Did very well to make that very thin contact. Win or lose, this is very good match practice for Robertson, who also was a semi-finalist in Group 2 last week before losing to Anthony McGill. The Masters is coming up next week, so he's match tight for that. Maintaining safety. Anxious look from Robertson to see whether the red that he's left nearest the left corner is possible. now worth a go, the way he played it. He wasn't leaving anything easy. But the red he attempted has come down to a possible position. Albeit, not a position in which it's easy to get good position on the colour.
Yellow ball. Three.
Well, he is on a red. Can you get on pink to middle? Delicate respotting by Brendan Moore. It's every referee's nightmare to drop a colour into a cluster of reds in a position like that.
Seventeen.
Wanted to get rid of the red which is preventing the black being potted to left corner. It slightly underran the cue ball. Nicely, appeared to know exactly what was going to happen to cue ball and pink. It's not just getting on the red, which is nearest the left corner, which is the problem. It's getting on it in such a way that it doesn't cannon the red next to it and not finish on the black. Well, if he can get through the gap, spot the red nearest the pocket, that's a very favourable run of the ball for him.
30.
It's been a very tricky break, requiring some good potting and some subtle positional play. May have tried to flick the red to the left of the black, but it was always going to be on the pink anyway. Into more straightforward territory now.
60.
Bobson has 485 centuries to his credit. So this should bring him one closer to the 500.
74. 75. 82. 83.
Very fine break this has been.
90.
Had a lot of problems to solve in its early stages. But now should have no further difficulty in reaching three figures.
98. Yeah, Robertson, 103.
And a fine break of 103 it was. It enables Neil Robertson to equalise at one all. First prize in the group, £3,000. Second prize, £2,000. And there are all the £100 per frame add-ins as well. So for both winner and runner-up, comprises not a bad return for 2 days' work.
Third frame. Mark Davis to break.
Whether the red next to the black is potable past the black may well determine what shot Robertson plays here. That red will pot past the black, so that's why Robertson didn't risk the red to right corner. Any shot to the ball cushion has got to take account of the red between blue and middle pocket. Robertson doesn't want to leave a cut on that. So there's no pot on from there. Not the right middle anyway. that possibility to corner. Davis calculating that he'd be unlucky to leave anything if he missed it. Excellent long pot. There's no better long potter in the game. Screwing into the bunch and out.
23.
Just about far enough. Robertson seems really in the groove now. I wouldn't rule out back-to-back centuries following his 103 in the last frame. Could have done with being a bit straighter on this red. At this angle, position not so straightforward.
47.
Not absolutely sure that's how he visualised it, but the main thing was he potted the ball and gave himself a chance of position. Perfectly judged. Sixty-one. Just a red and colour needed. 67. No back-to-back centuries, it would appear.
73.
But Robertson has already done enough to leave Davis needing two snookers.
Robertson, 73.
Could afford to attempt the double, and his opponent needing two snookers. Robertson following his 103 in the last frame. Another excellent 73. Just over cut, a
the strategy was to take four reds with blacks and then lay a snooker from the red, which is immediately underneath the pink.
One.
But, that plan is irrelevant now, surely. Robertson has prevented Davis from scoring.
16.
The best part of seven. Two frames.
Forty-eight. 53. 59. 66 in the frame.
Breaks of 73 and 66 from Robertson in that frame. Potted all the balls. And now he leads by 2 frames to 1. Repeat what I said earlier, group 4 commences tomorrow morning at 11 o'clock when Sean Murphy, Mark Allen and Karen Wilson join the competition. Mark Williams, Barry Hawkins, Ryan Day survive from today, as will the loser of this match. The winner of this match goes into the winner's group on March 1st and 2nd for much enhanced prize money. Brendan Boer, the referee, giving a rare opportunity to sit down.
It's keeping it warm for you.
Keeping it warm for you. Well, in the last two frames, Davis has been keeping it pretty warm for himself. He's hardly had a shot.
Frame 4, Neil Robertson to break.
Helpful for Davis that the green took the speed out of the cue ball. I don't think the potting angle on the outside red is such that Robertson could get round behind the back of the black. That's why he's leaving that shot alone. Worth a try, as he could also get the cue ball back into Boer. Pretty good shot, considering the lack of opportunity he's had in the last couple of frames.
Eight.
Highest spot on which black will go is the blue spot.
Nine. 15. Black
now back on its own spot. By developing a couple more reds. This is looking quite promising now.
Thirty-seven.
May not be above the pink.
43.
And that was sufficient. Not quite. Tried to carry the ready cannon more towards the left corner. Having a lengthy look to see if a plant can be made. If it can't, you won't want to move the red which is on the side cushion. And it turned out that the plant wasn't quite on.
Mark Davies, 49.
However, he was always getting the cue ball into balk.
Well, that's developed the safe red. He has left Davis a tempter in the form of the red, which is virtually on the black spot. It's just to the left of the spot though, so the putting angle may not be far from being off in the right middle. Opted for safety, a good one, and quite right too. Davis ignoring the safest red to reduce the chance of Robertson tearing up in one if he did get in.
Yep.
Well, that safety has largely succeeded in its objective of getting a red under or near a side cushion, but it was also a kick, which means that the cue ball didn't follow through quite as much as it should have done and has left this red starter to middle.
One. Eight.
Well, thinking about potting the blue, taking the cue ball off the balk cushion and trying to cannon the red on the side cushion, the right hand side cushion. If he comes past it, he may finish on one or both the reds in the lower half of the table. Decided it was too chancy to try to develop the red.
26.
And there were two reds that he could get on more easily. He although whether he has, I'm not absolutely sure. There is a theory that if the cue ball has got quite a bit of chalk on it, it does gather pace from a cushion, producing the so-called spriggy bounce. Now, is there enough angle on this red to try to develop the one on the
32.
Left-hand side cushion? Went past it. Unlucky. The blue was the ball to make a developing cannon, but
38.
That was spoilt by the double kiss. Still, only 11 in it now.
Neil Robertson, 38.
Not a good safety from Robertson though. He's trying to get the cue ball behind the black. Tricky, just a shade too thick. Might risk the double here. The cue ball will be going towards the ball cushion regardless. Would have been on the green had the red dropped. That was a better safety from Robertson. With Robertson and the referee Brendan Moore has looked to see whether Davis can get full ball contact. If he could and misses twice, then he would be on three misses an out warning.
Five miss. Neil Robertson,
pretty sure he can't hit the nearest red full ball. He's trying for a thin edge off the second red, the one by the green. Very nice. However, it has left a possible for Robertson.
albeit that Robertson is still 7 points behind. Does the red go past the green? Can't see from here. If this red goes in, Robertson should clear up for frame and match.
Seven.
He stops and considers. Maybe he's just off straight the wrong side. Couldn't get quite enough pace in the cue ball.
Ten.
Couldn't get quite enough side spin. Not to pot the yellow anyway. Of the yellow can Robertson hit? See enough to pot it, but it's wobbled and finished in a very good position for Davis, who will win the frame if he clears the pink.
Two.
5.
Straighter on the pink would be more certain, but I shouldn't think he'll miss this. Pink was all he needed.
20 in the frame.
So Mark Davis equalises at 2-all. It's all on the fifth frame decider. Looked as if Robertson was getting on top in those tactical exchanges, but when he did attempt the yellow from distance, he was unfortunate enough to see it run over a pocket.
Side frame. Mark Davis.
Safety to the bought cushion may lead to Davis being dropped in trouble by Robertson. If the cue ball had finished tight on the bought cushion, there would have been no possibility of that, but maybe Robertson can put him in trouble here. What a shot that was. Couldn't see a good safety, so knocked a long red in. I'd like to be able to clear the black spot in potting the black. Quickly things change. A minute or so ago, Davis looked in all sorts of trouble. Now he's got the first clear-cut chance.
Sixteen. 24.
Gradually thinning the reds out. Not a single red safe. Five reds, five blacks.
40. One. 48.
It won't have escaped Davis's attention that he's on a maximum here, but his first objective is to win frame and match. And he won't compromise winning the match by straining to keep black ball position. But that situation hasn't arisen yet.
57.
What effect is that going to have?
64.
On keeping black ball position. Moment, but keyboard finished under the edge of the nearest red. It's nine reds, nine blacks.
As
soon as he knocks this red in, he can concentrate on the maximum.
73.
Snookers, but more to the point.
73.
Will Davis make a 147? His highest breaking competition in his 26 year professional career is 143, twice. Still looking good.
80. 81.
Nine. 12 reds, 12 blacks.
96.
Just
is slightly more difficult now, and also of course he's got the tension to cope with. It's a big moment for him. Controlled the cannon well, didn't knock the second red anywhere near the cushion. Now is he round far enough? Here comes the 15th black. Seemed to get a very springy bounce, but it's okay.
120.
For yellow to middle. Three more balls to go. Marvellous! Everybody will be so pleased for him. One of the circuit's great stalwarts. In 26 years he's never made a maximum in competition, but he not only makes one, but does so in the deciding frame of Championship League Group 3.